Hello dear students, in today's class we are going to discuss about what is one atomic mass unit and what is one electron volt. In nuclear physics and atomic physics, mass is measured in atomic mass unit and energy is measured in electron volt. So let us define what is one atomic mass unit. One atomic mass unit. And this one atomic mass unit is represented by 1 AMU or AMU, and simply it is represented by U. So here 1 AMU or U stands for one atomic mass unit. Then what is one atomic mass unit? Then how to define the one atomic mass unit? One atomic mass unit is defined as one twelfth of, means 1/12 times of. So 1/12 of mass of an atom means here one atom, an atom of carbon 12 isotope. So what is one atomic mass unit here? So one atomic mass unit is defined as 1/12 of mass of an atom of carbon 12 isotope. Then how to find the mass of one atom of carbon 12 isotope? Already we know that mass of one mole of carbon 12 isotope is 12 gram. That is almost equal to its mass number. And why only we are going to use the carbon here? Because the carbon having the whole number atomic mass. That is why we are going to use the carbon isotope. Then mass of one mole of carbon 12 isotope that is equal to 12 gram. Okay, then one mole having the how many atoms? That is 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms. That is called Avogadro's number. So one mole containing how many atoms here? That is about 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms. So this number is called Avogadro's number. Means the mass of 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms of carbon 12 isotope is how much? 12 gram. Means we have to find the mass of one atom of carbon 12 isotope. I will write mass of 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms of carbon 12 isotope. So here the atomic number is 6, that is equal to 12 gram. So listen here, the one mole gas having the how many atoms here? So that is about, or one mole element having the how many atoms here? That is about 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms. Then now mass of one atom of carbon 12 6 isotope is equal to 12 gram divided by Avogadro's number. So I will take this value to the right hand side, that will be divided here. Then that is 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. And here this is mass of one atom of carbon 12 isotope. Okay, then so here the mass of one atom of carbon 12 isotope is taken in gram. Then by substituting this value in the definition, then we will get the value of one atomic mass unit. Okay, so one atomic mass unit is equal to 1 AMU is equal to 1/12 into mass of one atom of carbon 12 isotope, means mass of an atom of carbon 12 isotope. So what is the mass of one atom of carbon 12 isotope here? That is 12 divided by 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 into 10 to the power of 23, but that is in gram. Okay, here 12 get cancer. Then finally we got one atomic mass unit is equal to 0.1 by 6.023, that is about 0.166 into 10 to the power of minus 23 gram. So I will take this 10 to the power of 23 to the numerator, that becomes 10 to the power of minus 23. Then I will displace the decimal point after one digit in which direction? Right direction. Then I will write it is 1.66. So 10 to the power of minus 1, because in right direction after the one digit the decimal point is displaced. That is why 10 to the power of minus 1 into 10 to the power of minus 23 gram. Then it is 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 24 gram. So what is the value of one atomic mass unit in terms of gram? That is 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 24 gram. Then we have to convert this one to kg. Then 1 kg means 1000 gram. Already you know that 1 kg means 1000 gram, means 10 to the power of 3 gram. Then I will write 1 gram is equal to 1 by 10 to the power of 3 kg. Then 1 by 10 to the power of 3 kg means it is 10 to the power of minus 3 kg. So what is the value of 1 gram in terms of kg? That is 1 gram is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 kg. Then I will write. So 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 24 into 1 gram means here 10 to the power of minus 3 kg in terms of kg. We are going to write the one atomic mass in terms of kg. Then 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 24 into 10 to the power of minus 3, that is 10 to the power of minus 27. 10 to the power of minus 27 kg. So it is the value of one atomic mass unit in terms of kg. In terms of kg. Okay. Otherwise, we can write 1 U is equal to 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg. So this is the value of one atomic mass unit. So what is the value of one atomic mass unit in terms of kg? That is 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg. So how to convert kg to atomic mass unit? So I will take this value to the left hand side. How to convert kg to atomic mass unit? Okay, then I will take this value to the left hand side, that should be divided. Then 1 divided by 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 27 atomic mass unit. Remember these two formula. So one atomic mass unit in terms of kg is 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg. And 1 kg in terms of one atomic mass unit, that is 1 by 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 27. Then let us consider example. Already we know that what is the mass of the proton in terms of kg. Mass of a proton in terms of kg, that is 1.6726 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg. So I will convert the mass of the proton kg to the atomic mass unit. Then see here, 1.6726 into 10 to the power of minus 27. So here 1 kg in terms of atomic mass unit, that is 1 divided by, I will write here only, that is 1 divided by 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 27. Here kg to atomic mass unit. Then 10 to the power of minus 27, 10 to the power of minus 27 get cancelled, and its answer is about 1.00740 atomic mass unit. So what is the mass of the proton in terms of atomic mass unit? That is 1.00740 atomic mass unit. Remember this value. And what is the mass of the neutron in terms of atomic mass unit? Already we know that the mass of the neutron in terms of kg. Mass of the neutron in terms of kg. That is 1.6750 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg. So it is the mass of the neutron in terms of kg. So listen here, the mass of the proton is 1.6726 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg, but mass of the neutron is 1.6750 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg. Almost all these masses are equal, but here the mass of the neutron is greater than the mass of the proton. Then we have to convert kg to atomic mass unit. Then mass of the neutron is equal to 1.6750 into 10 to the power of minus 27. So 1 kg in terms of atomic mass unit, that is 1 by 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 27. Here kg to atomic mass unit. Then here again 10 to the power of minus 27, 10 to the power of minus 27 get cancel. On solving this one, we will get the value is about 1.00885. It is atomic mass unit. Then what is the mass of the neutron in terms of atomic mass unit? So 1.00885 atomic mass unit. And in similar manner, we are going to find the mass of the electron. So what is the mass of the electron in terms of kg? That is 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg. Here the mass of the electron is negligible compared to the mass of the proton and mass of the neutron, because mass of the proton and mass of the neutron is in the order of 10 to the power of minus 27 kg, but mass of the electron is in the order of 10 to the power of minus 31 kg. Here the 10 to the power of minus 31 kg is less than 10 to the power of minus 27 kg. Okay, then again we have to convert this kg to atomic mass unit. 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 into 1 kg in terms of atomic mass unit, that is 1 by 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 27 atomic mass unit. So here 9.1 divided by 1.66, this number is greater than 1. Means we will get that it is about 5.48 into 10 to the power of minus 31 into 10 to the power of plus 27, because 10 to the power of minus 27 is taken to the numerator, means that becomes plus. Then 10 to the power of minus 31 into 10 to the power of 27, that is 10 to the power of minus 4. So mass of the electron is equal to 5.48 into 10 to the power of minus 4 atomic mass unit. So we will write 0.000548. So 5.48 into 10 to the power of minus 4 means 5.48 divided by 10,000. That gives the 0.000548 atomic mass unit. So I will round up this this value to the 0.00055 atomic mass unit. So this is the mass of the electron in terms of atomic mass unit. See here, mass of the proton in terms of atomic mass unit, that is 1.00740. And mass of the neutron in terms of atomic mass unit, 1.00885 atomic mass unit. And mass of the electron in terms of atomic mass unit, that is 0.00055 atomic mass unit. So by observing these values, the mass of the neutron is greater than the mass of the proton, and mass of the proton is greater than mass of the electron. But compared to these two masses, the mass of the electron is very, very small, means that is negligible. That is why the whole mass of the atom, that depends on the mass of the nucleus. Next, what is 1 electron volt? So 1 electron volt is the unit of energy in the atomic physics and nuclear physics. In atomic physics and nuclear physics, the energy is measured in electron volt. Then what is 1 electron volt? 1 electron volt. And what is the value of 1 electron volt? So already you studied about 1 electron volt in the dual nature of radiation and matter. Okay. Then what is 1 electron volt? 1 electron volt is the energy gained by an electron, means energy gained by 1 electron is energy gained or possessed. Energy gained by an electron. An electron, when it is accelerated through, it is means here the electron, when it is accelerated through, when it is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt, when it is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt, when it is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt. See here, let us consider it is positive and it is negative. Then, so it is positive terminal of the battery, and this electrode is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, means this electrode is positive potential and this electrode is at negative potential. So here, due to the force of repulsion, the electron is repelled by the negative potential and this electron is attracted by the positive potential. There is a force of attraction between positive and negative, and there is a force of repulsion between negative and negative, because the electron is negatively charged, means this electron is accelerated. So this electron is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt. How much potential difference is applied here? 1 volt. The energy gained by this electron is called, that is 1 electron volt. Then what is the value of 1 electron volt? So already we know that what is the definition of potential difference. So that is potential difference is equal to work done per charge. So on which charge here the work is done? Sorry, work is done on the electron. Okay. Then work done is equal to charge into potential difference. So here the work is done on the electron by the potential difference of 1 volt. Then it is electron volt. Charge on the 1 electron, that is E, and into potential difference V. Then this work done is converted into energy. That energy is called 1 electron volt. Then it is 1 electron volt. Then what is the charge on the electron? That is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. 19 coulomb. And the potential difference, applied potential difference, that is 1 volt. That is 1 volt. Then coulomb into volt, that is joule. So 1 electron volt is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb volt. Then 1 coulomb volt means here 1 joule. So that is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joule. This is 1 electron volt. Okay. Then, so how to convert the 1 electron volt to joule? By multiplying 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joule. Okay. Then how to convert joule to electron volt? Then 1 joule is equal to, I will take this value to the left hand side, that is 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 electron volt. So this is joule to electron volt and this is electron volt to joule. We are going to use this formula only when we are going to convert electron volt to joule. we are going to use this formula only when we are going to convert joule to electron volt. So this is about 1 electron volt.